Hello, good evening, my dear students. I, Rakesh Talreja, welcome you all again to the India's largest online learning platform, GradeUp. Yeah, a very good evening to everyone. Already the students have arrived. Yes, Ram, Janani, Srinivasan, Thomas, Arya, Vaibhav, Vishal, everyone. Hello. Wish you all a very good evening. Hope you are enjoying your studies. Hope you are safe at your home. Yeah, Anjali, Vaibhav. Yes, Vaibhav, we are just about to start the session. Suyash, Jaru and Jamal, also very good evening to you, my dear students. So, as you all know, we are just going through the NILET important question series for the NILET 2020 examination. To start with the proceedings, yes, Shikhar, Srikant, good evening, namaste. Yeah, namaste everyone. And that's how, you know, this is very important in these days because, you know, the coronavirus is, you know, day by day in our country also it is increasing in numbers. The cases are coming up lots and lots. So please try to, you know, avoid shaking your hands. If you are greeting also someone, say namaste. That's the better mode of, you know, greeting anyone. And also remember the guidelines provided by World Health Organization. Keep washing your hands. Okay, keep washing your hands regularly by soap or Dettol. Properly, you know, on the front, on the back, between the fingers, rub properly and rinse properly and close your tap with a neat and clean towel. And if you have any concerns, if you have any queries or if you feel any symptoms for coronavirus, you have the national control room set up. The contact numbers are provided. Do not hesitate in calling this. Stay safe. Make yourself safe, your family and your nation safe. Okay, as you know, the lockdown period is going on. So please, yeah, Vibhav, stay safe and stay at home. Vikas Mishra, no, I have taken when you know some good questions have been asked. If you go through my previous number systems lecture or quant section, I have taken questions from STA also. Okay, what happens in sometimes ST, you know, questions are direct, you know, ki like for example, if I give an example, sequential circuit output depends upon. Today we are going to talk about sequential circuits only. Okay, so that is just, you know, one line definition which you all know. I am trying to take more and more of the numerical question where students might be stuck. ठीक है तो इट्स नॉट लाइक आई एम ट्राइंग टू अवॉइड एनी एसटीए पेपर आई हैव टेकन बोथ बट एसटीए फॉर द टॉपिक्स आई एम टेकिंग हैज लॉट्स ऑफ यू नो डायरेक्ट डेफिनेशन क्वेश्चन बट रादर देन दैट व्हाट एवर न्यूमेरिकल्स आई हैव टेकन इन द नंबर सिस्टम एंड इन द क्वांट क्लासेस ओके yes Shanmuka, I have received your mail. I replied to one of your mail also, and definitely I'll reply to. I received another mail also from your end. I'll reply to it. Do not worry. Yeah, Satvik, very good evening. Okay, dear students. So let me start as always by introducing myself again. If you are new to this session, many of you, I remember your names. You're already following the previous session. So I am Rakesh Talreja, and I've secured All India rank 9th in the GATE examination, and from EC and EC branch, and I've done my Masters in Engineering ME. From Microelectronics, Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore, say, and I nearly have 10 plus years of teaching experience for GATE and Engineering Services and other PSUs exam. And I have been in this journey of myself. I have mentored more than 20,000 plus students all across the India in various cities of our country. And my area of expertise is Engineering Mathematics Quant, which is common for all. Digital electronics, which is common for EC Electrical and CS. Many of you might be CS students for the NILET session. And other, apart from that, for EC Electrical, I take EMT, signals and control. This is my main area of expertise where I've been taking lectures from several years in this. Okay. Yes, Shanmukha, I'll reply you my ISC experience. Rather than that, I'm even planning to make, you know, a session for all you guys. Ki how is the life in ISC? Okay. But I'll reply to, you know, I've already told if you have any general questions apart from the topic of this session, you can ask me through mail or you can ask me in the GradeUp app. You can, you know, already my name is displayed on the screen. You can just open your GradeUp app. I hope you all are using the GradeUp app. Just open the GradeUp app and search me by the name of Rakesh Talreja. Okay. Vikas, no, level of STA and Scientist B are not the same. It is different. Scientist B mostly has little better questions. It's little better questions, but even sometimes ST also is good question, but scientist B, you can expect little more questions. Okay. So yeah, again, once again, very good evening. If I've missed anyone's comment, and let's start with the session. So see, dear students, let me tell you very beginning in this session, ki a topic like flip-flop or counter, students little bit fear about it. But as you all know, we just have around a 1 hour session. So my main intention will be again on solving the problems based on counters or single flip-flop circuits. I will definitely discuss briefly about flip-flops whenever question comes up. I do have some slides where I've prepared some flip-flop basic details, but I shall first start with counters because anyways in the counters, we are going to use flip-flops. Yeah, Satvik and Monica, good evening again. So we are in the counter design. Ultimately, we are going to use flip-flops. So whenever required, I'll discuss about a specific flip-flop, because if I go by the complete theory of sequential, 1 hour, even 10 hours are not sufficient. Okay. So I again repeat, it's not a complete digital course. It's a nihilist important question of counters. And do not worry. You know, do not worry. We will take up. I have even taken some questions from gate, good level questions. So I'll try to, give you each and every level. Yes, Ashish and Neal, I'll told you, I'll reply to general queries whenever I get time in between the questions or in the grade up app. Okay, I'll keep on moving with the session right now, because already, Jamal, scientist B questions level not same as guide. Okay, maybe one or two questions you'll get as gate level, but mostly, yeah, you can say gate 1 mark level. You can say gate 1 mark level. Dilip, yes, whatever, you know, whatever is possible in 1 hour session, definitely. See, do not worry. Whatever questions I take, na, with questions, you will understand the concept. What I'm telling is, students, practically, aap hi soche ki within 1 hour, I will not be able to cover the whole theory. But yeah, I have selected essay questions like here so that you are able to solve questions. Okay, so if you're preparing an exam like Nihilist, obviously, I also assume that you might have, you might have already prepared for GATE or ESE. So some basic concepts are already there. If not, let's go to the question. Let's go to the question and some concept will be clear to you. Okay, so students, let's start now. Praveen, good evening. Now, I'm directly starting with the design of counters, where, you know, what is a counter? Okay, any sequential circuit which counts upon a particular sequence. It may be a regular sequence, a regular binary sequence. Like if I talk about a 3-bit counter, it may be counting from 000, 001. I'm going to talk about this design, 010, etc. up to 111. Or you can design any counter which counts upon any sequence. For example, you want to design a counter which counts only even numbers, so it has 010, 100, 110, and then back to 000. Okay, Merlin, no, Nihilist questions are not as tough as gate questions. See, in today's lectures, I have presented both gate and Nihilist questions. Some questions, very few, are equivalent to gate. Rest others are little easy. Take a direct. So gate 1 marker question. Mostly, you have to focus on gate 1 marker question. Okay. चलिए सो काउंटर्स बेसिकली यू नो व्हेनेवर वी टॉक अबाउट काउंटर्स देयर आर टू कैटेगरीज ऑफ काउंटर्स सिंक्रोनस काउंटर्स एंड रिपल काउंटर्स आई एम गोइंग टू टॉक द डिजाइन ऑफ बोथ लेट्स स्टार्ट विद सिंक्रोनस विद द डिजाइन इटसेल्फ आई विल मेक द डेफिनेशन क्लियर ओके तो व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय सिंक्रोनस काउंटर प्लीज नोट दैट ऑल द फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स व्हेन ऑल द फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स आर कनेक्टेड बाय द कॉमन क्लॉक इट इज रेफर्ड टू एज अ सिंक्रोनस काउंटर design. And here I am taking an example of designing a 3-bit binary up counter. Now, what do I mean by binary up counter? Binary up counter means which counts all the 3-bit binary sequence. Like here it is shown. This is known as what? This is known as the state diagram of the problem. So 000, 001, 010, 011, etc., etc., etc. It reaches the maximum 3-bit number 111. And then it again cycles to the initial state 000 and keep on going there. Okay. Alanka, sir, if last 30 years ke gate question kiye, to kya wo repeat honge? Yes, you have chances of repetition. And agar not directly repeat hue, so, you know, some alterations, little bit alterations ke saath question clear milenge. But I guarantee you one thing, Alankar, if you are solving last 30 year gate questions, you know, comfortably, if you have understood all the 30 years gate question comfortably, then Nihilist will become very, 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 very simple. Theek hai? Take it as a guarantee. Okay. Yes. So let's begin with the design. So what, you know what I want to do? I want to design a circuit which counts upon 000 to 111 and back to 000 in synchronous. Synchronous matlab all the flip-flops will be connected by common clock. Okay. Minitube, yes, you're a little bit late, but do not worry, we haven't started any concept yet. So we are just about to start. And students, if you are, if you are motivated, if you have been following my previous sessions and if you are enjoying right now, so please do not miss to hit the like button. Please do hit the like button. And now let's go to the design of synchronous counter. Now look at this excitation table. Okay. Now because I'm going to use T flip-flops, I'll briefly introduce a T flip-flop to you. Okay. So as I've told, I've prepared some basic slides about the flip-flops. Not the internal diagram, because if I tell the internals of every flip-flop, 2-3 hours will be gone in that only. Okay, chaliye. Naveen Tosh, where can I search for your gate-based digital logic lecture? See, very soon I'll be coming. We are launching the gate course where I'll be having some subjects. So do not worry, you'll be able to find my lectures very soon on the GradeUp app also. Okay. Yeah. चलिए, सो हाउ डज अ टी फ्लिप फ्लॉप बिहेव्स? जस्ट यू नो, डू नॉट इवन लुक एट दिस, दिस इज द फॉर्मल कैरेक्टरिस्टिक टेबल. जस्ट रिमेंबर, इफ टी इज इक्वल टू जीरो, इट इज गोइंग टू रिप्रेजेंट सेम स्टेट. सेम स्टेट मतलब द नेक्स्ट स्टेट. आई ऑलवेज रिप्रेजेंट द नेक्स्ट स्टेट ऑफ अ फ्लिप फ्लॉप बाय क्यू प्लस. क्यू प्लस विल बी इक्वल टू क्यू. एंड इफ टी इज इक्वल टू वन, इफ द इनपुट इज हाई हेयर, if t is equal to 1, then this is known as toggle state. Because of the word toggle only, this flip-flop is named as t flip-flop. And toggle means basically complement. Q plus will be equal to Q complement. Whatever is the state, if it is 0, it is converted to 1. If it is 1, it is converted to 0. Now look at this characteristic table. See, if t is 0, Q and Q plus are same. Following? If t is 1, Q and Q plus are complemented. Q is 0, Q plus. Q plus matlab what? I again repeat, Q plus I mean the next state. If t is 1, the state is complemented. Again, if t is 0, q remains as same. Q is 1, q plus next is also 1. If t is again 1, so q is toggled. 1 is converted to 0. Clear everyone? So that is the only basic thing you have to remember about the t flip flop. And then when I simply put this truth table in a k map, or directly, not required k map because it's a two variable. See, where is the q plus high? Where is the Q plus high? When both the input bits are different, that means it is behaving as a XOR functionality. So I can simply write Q plus is what? XOR of Q and T. It is just the XOR of Q and T. Or I can write down the XOR formula Q T bar plus Q bar T. A B bar plus A bar B is the XOR formula. VC education, sorry I'm late. So do not worry, we haven't crossed any, you know, important thing as of now. I've just started with the counters. I'm designing a 3-bit synchronous up counter using T flip-flops. I've given a basic idea about T flip-flop. Okay, I hope you have already studied this flip-flop. If not, just remember these two conditions about T flip-flop. If T is 0, the state will not change. If T is 1, the state will be toggled, and this is the characteristic equation. Okay, Arijit Paul sir, why can't I see the video? No, I think you can just check your connection. Yeah, everyone else, are you able to see the video? I don't think anyone else having the same problem because I haven't received any comment. Yes, kindly, can you comment? Anyone else? Yes, this is important. Can you all comment? Are you able to see the video? Is the audio audible to everyone? Any problems? Yeah, please reply everyone. I'm waiting for your replies. Okay, so, yeah, VC education, thank. Okay. So, we are onto the design of this synchronous counter. Srinivasan, thank you for your reply. So, see, when the flip-flop, because it's a 3-bit counter, I'll be using 3 flip-flops, and the outputs of the 3 flip-flops will be named as Q2, Q1, and Q0. Okay, so, let's say, look at this table. If Q2, Q1, Q0 is in the current state 0, 0, 0, what will be the next state 0, 0, 1? Because I am designing up counter, because after 0, it is 1. After 1, it is 2 and 3 and 4, etc, etc, etc. So if it is 0, 0, 0, next state is 0, 0, 1. If it is 0, 0, 1, next state is 0, 1, 0. The same state diagram has been converted to a table now. 0, 1, 0 ka next state kya hoga? 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1, next state, 1, 0, 0, etc, etc, etc. And when you reach the 1, 1, 1, last state, what I told, after 111, the next state will be 0, 0, 0. Yes, gate ka question aega and even nihilate questions will come up. Okay, so that is my current state and next state relation. Now, I have already told you with respect to T flip-flop, I'll again write here, if T is 0, it represents same state condition. If T is 1, it represents toggle. Toggle means complement state condition. So please look at this, how to decide what is the T input that I should keep for this state transition. Everyone listen carefully. Everyone listen carefully. Raghav, I'm confused about Q and Q plus. See, Q, I've already told, Q means the current value of the device. And Q plus means the next value, whatever be the upcoming. When I apply an input, the circuit will change the output. So what is the next output? That is Q plus. And what is the currently stored in the flip-flop is Q. Clear, Raghav? Simply remember by this. Okay. So look at this. Please, everyone, look at the Q plus Q2 column. I'm focusing on Q2 right now. So please follow carefully. Q2, 0 to 0. See the transition on Q2, 0 to 0. Matlab same. And if it is same, what should be the T value? 0. So that is why look at this. I have put the T value 0 here. Clear, everyone? Now, second row. Q2 0 to 0, matlab again same, so T value 0, 0 to 0, same. Now look at this transition, Q2 0 and Q2 plus is 1, matlab Q2 is toggled. And how will be Q2 toggled if the T input is 1? Okay, so we are just solving the reverse, excitation table means telling the value of the input when you know the state transition. Okay, when you notice state transition. So Q2 has toggled. So what should be the T input for this toggle transition? 1. Now next entry, 1 to 1, matlab same. 1 to 1 is same. Synchronous, asynchronous counter explanation completed. No, we have just started with the synchronous counter explanation. So look at this, 1 to 1 same. So T value 0. 1 to 1 same, T input 0. Again 1 to 1 same, T input 0. And now look at this last entry, 1 to 0. It is toggled. And how will a state toggle when the T input is equal to 1? Okay, so this is the truth table for TQ2. Now what you have to ultimately do, you have to write down every T input as a function of the current state Q2, Q1 and Q0. So you all can solve the K map. By solving the K map, I have directly written the answer here. I'm just giving you TQ2 as of now. When I solve TQ2 in the K map, I get the answer as Q1, Q0. Okay, now look at the Q1. Come on, everyone, keep following. I'm now going for Q1. Look at this entry, 0 to 0, same. So T value 0. 0 to 1, different. So this T value is high. 1 to 1, same. 1 to 0, toggle. Toggle means T input, make it as 1. Okay? 0 to 0, same. Okay. 0 to 1, toggle. Toggle means T input 1. 1 to 1, same. Okay. So T input 0. 1 to 0, toggle. So because of toggle, T input I have taken as high. Okay? Now look at the Q0 column. Next is Q0 column. And please mind that Q0 will be toggled at every clock. See, 0 to 1. 1 to 0, 0 to 1, 1 to 0, 0 to 1, etc., etc., etc. So Q0 always makes a transition. So what should be the TQ0? What should be the T input here? It is always fixed at 1. So that is why I don't need to solve TQ0. It is fixed at 1. This is always fixed at 1. You can see LSB always toggles 0 to 1, then 0, 1, 0, 1, alternate, alternate, alternate. Okay. Now Q1. I have also solved this TQ1, and TQ1 is high at 4 places. I will put these 4 highs in the K map and I will solve, and after solving I get this TQ1. TQ1 is equal to Q0. Okay, TQ1 is equal to Q0. So I have derived all the T inputs for the 3 T flip-flops, and then very quickly I am presenting the final circuit diagram in front of you. See, this is Q0, this is Q1, this is Q2, and this is the clock. Again, I go back to the basic definition. What is a synchronous counter? Where all the flip-flops use the same clock. Okay, all the flip-flops, see, all the flip-flops have been fed with the same common clock. This clock is common to all. This clock is common to all. Okay, and now look at the derivations. What is the TQ2 input? T input of the two flip-flop. It is Q1, Q0. So I have taken a connection from Q1 and Q0. Taken to AND gate to multiply, and this AND gate produces the output Q1 Q0, and it is going to TQ2. Okay. Next, what is TQ1? Is just equal to Q0. So see, this Q0 is taken, and this is fed here directly where? To the TQ1 input. Okay, sorry, this is Q0. Q0 is taken and fed directly to TQ1. And next, what is TQ0? It is fixed at 1. TQ0. Okay, it is missing here. I'll mention here. Please note that TQ0 is equal to 1. And that completes the design of a synchronous counter. That completes the design of a synchronous counter. Okay? Yeah. So before taking up question, I'm explaining one design of synchronous and ripple counter. Okay, I keep on repeating again, repeat ki my intention in this around 1 hour lecture is to make you comfortable with problem. That is why whatever is the minimum theory required, that I will cover. And because if I cover the whole theory, around 8-10 hours will go only for flip-flops and counters. Okay. Okay. So we'll cover the important concepts through question. This is synchronous counter. Quickly, immediately, I'm taking the design of a ripple counter, and there I'll make you understand also ki what is a ripple counter. Now, see, ripple counter. In a ripple counter, the flip-flop, I'll explain this design. Look at this. And a Q0, Q1, and Q2. See, this is my LSB flip-flop. Always in the number system, I call the position 0 for LSB. Okay. And this is Q2, this is Q1, and this is Q0. So this is LSB, and this is my MSB flip-flop. See, what was there in the previous design, as you can see, this clock is common to all the flip-flop. All the flip-flops are served by the same clock, and that is synchronous. But what is happening here? The clock is only applied to the LSB flip-flop. Make a note that in ripple counter, the clock is only applied to LSB flip-flop, and then the output of every flip-flop goes to the clock of the next flip-flop. Output of every flip-flop. That means Q0 output goes to the clock of the next flip-flop. Q1 output goes to the clock of the for the next flip flop. Okay? Yeah, Mehmooda, this is asynchronous counter only. This is a ripple counter only. Ripple counter or asynchronous counter. That I repeat this, I read this together. The flip-flop output transition serves as a source for triggering the other flip-flop. Matlab, serves as a clock of the next flip-flop. Okay, so that is the design of a ripple counter. Now, how do these counters work? Okay, let's understand this, everyone, very, very carefully. Now, as you can see this, I want to explain you one thing here. As you see in this flip-flop, what is this symbol? With the clock, I have used this symbol. I'll tell you, anyone, what is this symbol? Yes? See, this symbol basically means that you have a negative edge triggered. Negative edge triggered flip-flop. Negative edge triggered flip-flop means what? That flip-flop will only respond to the negative edge of the clock. Now, what is clock? Clock is a periodic waveform that I have applied to the circuit. And because all the flip-flops are negative edge triggered, yes, Sasidhar and Charit, the negative edge is your correct answer. When I have applied the clock, see, periodically, because clock is a periodic waveform, after every fixed interval of time, this negative edge will keep coming. And whenever this negative edge matlab transition from 1 to 0. Whenever this negative edge comes, the flip-flop will respond. Respond to what? Respond to the input applied at T. Okay. Or JK. Yeah, here they have used JK. So I'll also make you go to the JK flip-flop. Okay. So some numbers have gone missing here in diagram. I'll mention. See. All make all the JK inputs as 1, 1. See, all the JK inputs are 1, 1. This is J, this is K, and these are the Q outputs. Now, because synchronous I've designed by T, here also we can design by T, but I've taken a JK example. So, I'll also make you go towards the basics of the JK flip-flop, okay? You should know just the state transition of JK flip-flop. So, please note with me, JK flip-flop, when J equal to 1 and K equal to 0, it represents set state. I'll write here. It represents set state. Set state matlab the next state of the flip-flop. Next state ko main kaise represent karta hun? Q plus will be high. Okay? So, this is the first point to note. The second point to note, that when J is equal to 0 and K is equal to 1, it represents the reset state. Reset state matlab next state will be 0. Q plus will be fixed at 0. Case number 3, if both J and K are 0, 0 means the latch, the flip-flop will remain in the same state. That means Q plus equal to Q. Q plus equal to Q. Yeah, hello Ravi Shekhar. And look at this fourth condition. If J and K are both equal to 1, it represents, like the T flip-flop, it represents the toggle condition. Toggle means Q plus will be complemented. Q plus will be equal to Q bar. These are the four conditions of JK flip-flop. I repeat, J1 K0 set. J0 K1 reset. Set matlab high, reset matlab low. J0 K0 no change, matlab same state. J1 K1 toggle. Toggle matlab Q plus equal to Q complement. Okay. So these are the four states that you have to remember for JK flip-flop while solving. Even I'll give you some more questions on JK flip-flop. So you have to remember these four conditions, and okay, I'll come back to this diagram now. Okay. So what I'm telling is all the, for this circuit diagram, all the JK inputs are fixed at 1. Okay. And if all the JK inputs are fixed at 1, if J equal to K equal to 1, what is that state? I've already told. It represents toggle state. Okay. But when will the flip-flop respond? When will the flip-flop respond? When you get the negative edge of the clock. Chaliye. Now, look at the analysis of this. Okay. I am solving this here together with you, my dear students. Q2, Q1, Q0. Q2, Q1, Q0, always take all the flip-flops as initially reset. Agar question mein bola jaye take a different state, then you can choose a different state. But commonly, you have to select 0, 0, 0 as the starting state. All the flip-flops as reset. Okay, so Q2, Q1, Q0, 0, 0, 0. And what is clock pulse? I again sketch here. I have already told clock is a periodic square waveform that I have applied to the device. And because all the flip-flops here are negative edge triggered, so we will be operating the device on the negative edges. Now this is the external clock, the user. You have applied already to the circuit, and where you have applied the clock, repeat again, where you have applied the clock? On the LSB flip-flop. LSB matlab Q naught. This is my LSB. So see, clock is an external waveform, and after every certain time this keeps on coming. Okay, this negative edges, this is important for you. This negative edges come, and when the negative edge come, this will toggle. Why this will toggle? See, the input J and K fix that one, and if input J and K is fixed that one, it represents ultimately toggle condition. So this flip-flop state output will be toggled, complemented. So in place of 0, I have written 1. Okay, in place of 0, I have written as 1. Now, yes, Raghav, I don't think I'll be getting sufficient time in this session to cover race around condition, but I again repeat, open up the GridUp app, find me, tag me, and I'll give you a detailed description of race around condition. That's what I can do. Okay, so Q naught changes from 0 to 1. What is this edge? This is a positive transition. This is not a negative transition. And then Q naught goes to what? Q naught goes to the next clock input of the Q1 flip-flop. Okay, so what is the clock arriving here? What is the clock transition I require? Negative transition, 1 to 0. But what is the transition happened? 0 to 1. Matlab, this flip-flop will not respond. Okay. And if this flip-flop will not respond, see, the output Q1 goes to the clock of the next flip-flop. Now, what is the transition on Q1? There is no transition. And because there is no transition, there is no change for the Q2 as well. Clear, 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 everyone? Yes. Chaliye. Now next, after some time, clock is a periodic waveform. Automatically, after some more time, the next negative edge will come. And when the next negative edge will come, this LSB will always toggle. Because again, I see, where is the clock applied? LSB. So LSB will toggle when the clock arrives. Now look at this transition. It is 1 to 0 transition. That is negative edge. And because it is negative edge, the next flip-flop will be active. Q0 goes to the Q1 flip-flop, and what is the edge on Q0? It is a negative transition. It will make Q1 active, and Q1 will also toggle. Why this is toggled? Clock aa gaya, J or K inputs 1, and whenever J and K inputs 1, toggle should happen. Okay, so I am making Q1 also as toggle. Okay, now what is the transition on Q1? 0 to 1. 0 to 1 matlab positive edge, and positive edge means the next flip-flop is not active. I want negative edges for the flip-flop to be active. I want negative edges. Okay. Then, after some more time, the clock third edge, negative edge will come, and LSB will again toggle. But what is the transition on LSB? 0 to 1, positive transition, next flip-flop will not work. What is the transition on Q1? No transition. The next flip-flop will not work. It will remain in the same state. So 0, 1, 1. If you are able to see, yeah, a regular binary sequence is coming up. Regular binary sequence is coming up. Okay, now next, again after some more time, the clock negative edge will come, and after the clock negative edge arrives, what happens? LSB will toggle, and LSB toggles matlab 1 to 0. LSB changes from 1 to 0, and this is again a negative transition, and when Q0 gives a negative transition, what happens? Next, Q1 is active, and Q1 will also toggle. And what is the change in Q1? 1 to 0, this is also a negative edge. And when you get a negative edge on Q1, what will happen? Q2 will also toggle. Q2 will also be active. And you get the next state as 1 double 0. So after 3, you get a 4. So what is the case you are getting? Ultimately, you are getting a binary up counter. Similarly, is this clear to everyone? Similarly, you will keep solving and you will get the next state as 101. Then you will get 110. Then you will get 111. And finally, after 111, you are going to get 000. Okay, that is how ripple counting continues. Ripple counting continues. Now, a question hai ki why we call it as a ripple? Why we call this asynchronous counter as a ripple? See, what do I mean by ripple? Ripple action means propagation action. What happened in the synchronous? What happened in the synchronous? Understand very important point. Synchronous, you apply the clock to all the flip-flops. That means externally, you are triggering every flip-flop. By yourself. You are triggering every flip-flop by yourself. But what is happening in the ripple? What is the flip-flop on which you apply the clock? What is the flip-flop onto which you apply the clock? Only the LSB flip-flop. Do you apply the clock here? Do you apply the clock here? No, I do not apply the clock to Q1 and Q2. But I only apply the clock to LSB. And then the output of Q0 triggers the next. The output of Q1 triggers the next, and etc, etc, etc. So it is a propagation chain going on. I will only hit the LSB. LSB will trigger the next. Next will trigger the next. Next will trigger its next. And this keeps on going on. And that is what is known as ripple action. Ripple basically means a type of propagation action. So the clock is propagated from the LSB to the MSB. Mahmuda, yes, clock a ripple one to another. So that's what I'm explaining. Ripple matlab propagation. So the clock action propagates. The clock propagates. You only apply, you only trigger the LSB, and automatically every flip-flop is triggered internally by its previous flip-flop. Okay, so that is why we call this asynchronous counter as a ripple counter. And this is the count sequence. So ultimately, it is a design of the same binary up counter only. It is a design of the same binary up counter that we have designed using synchronous. I've given you two designs. One was synchronous, another one is ripple. Both are performing the same state diagram. Okay, let's look at this. Both are performing the same state diagram only. Yes, my dear students. They are counting from 000 to 111. 000 to 111. But what is the difference in two then? If they are performing the same operation, what is the difference in two? Tell you. So before I tell you the difference, Raghav, I'm going to tell you something about positive edge triggering also. I'm giving you one final conclusion. See, here, whenever you have a question on ripple counter, it is very easy. Remember 4 points I'm telling you. Applicable to all ripple counter question. So see, what is the clock connection I've used here? Okay, I'll erase some of the details. Look at this connection only. What is the clock connection? This is Q and going to where? Negative edge triggered device. Okay, so Q to negative edge. Okay, so if I just consider this picture only, I have taken the clock connection from Q output to negative edge, Q output to negative edge, and what is the conclusion I have derived? See, what is the count sequence? It is up. There can be two types of sequence, up or down. Down matlab it can be reverse. 000, then 111. First it goes to 7, then 110, then 101. It counts in the down manner. That is also possible. Okay. Yeah, Dhakar, good evening. Pretty late today. Okay. So, that's what I'm telling. Whenever you have Q to negative edge, what we have derived, the count sequence, it turns out to be a up counter. Clear everyone? So I'm giving you 4 points, four very important points. Remember, with respect to ripple counter, then we will see Jamal, SR counters are not used because of invalid state. Okay, race conditions and invalid state are two big problems with SR flip flop. Okay, much more details you can ask me on the GradeUp app. Fine. Chaliye. So Q to negative edge. This is very important. Q to negative edge. What do you get? Q to negative edge, I get a up counter. Okay. Now, if I change a connection, if I take the connection from Q bar to negative edge, that means it may also be possible. Keep noticing, dear students, ki instead of Q, I take the connection from Q bar for every flip-flop, not only for one flip-flop. Whatever I'm telling, it should be applicable to every flip-flop. So if the connection is from this Q, similarly from this Q to clock, so Q bar to negative edge, if I solve, I'm giving you the direct conclusion, it will come up as a down counter. Okay. It will come up as a down counter. Okay. Similarly, again going to Q. The first one was Q to negative edge. If you take Q to positive edge, it will again come up as a down counter. And lastly, Q to negative edge again, if I make, it will again come up as up counter. So please note down these very important points. Very helpful for solving the questions. Very, very helpful for solving the questions. Yes, please take the screenshot. This will be very helpful for solving the counter questions. Okay. Very helpful for solving the counter questions. Yeah. Comfortable, dear students? So remember these four connections, Q to negative edge or Q bar to negative edge, or else Q to positive edge or this one is Q bar to negative edge. I've miswriting. This is Q bar to negative edge. Okay, now kindly take the improved screenshot. Okay. Yeah, Shubhangi, first and last point was the same. I've corrected. It is Q bar to negative h. Sorry, q bar to positive h. Yeah, make it. This is the final answer. Q bar to positive h. ठीक है, इट विल बी अप काउंटर. ओके, यस यस प्रितेश, फॉर पॉजिटिव एज इट विल बी डाउन काउंटर, बट व्हेन यू टेक द पॉजिटिव एज फ्रॉम क्यू, इफ आई अगेन टेक टू क्यू बार, इट विल बी अप काउंटर. या, सात्विक, आई हैड यू नो मिस्टेकनली रिटन द लास्ट पॉइंट. इट इज क्यू बार टू पॉजिटिव एज. नाउ इट्स करेक्ट. ठीक है, नाउ इट्स करेक्ट. यस एवरीवन, ओके, या क्यू बार टू पॉजिटिव एज सही करण. ओके, सो फाइनली फाइनली टेक द स्क्रीनशॉट एंड वील बी सॉल्विंग क्वेश्चन नाउ. ओके, सो आई हैव फ्यू मोर कॉन्सेप्ट टू डिस्कस. आई हैव फ्यू मोर कॉन्सेप्ट टू डिस्कस, बट आई एम टेकिंग यू डायरेक्टली टू वन क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस काइंड. आई एम टेकिंग यू डायरेक्टली टू वन क्वेश्चन ऑफ दिस काइंड. ठीक है, काइंडली टेक एंड गिव मी दिस आंसर. वेरी इजी, आई हैव टेकन अ गेट क्वेश्चन. ठीक है, आई एम टेकिंग सम थ्री और फोर गेट क्वेश्चन, देन आई एम गोइंग टू द नाइलेट क्वेश्चन. काइंडली टेक डाउन दिस क्वेश्चन प्लीज. I'll come back to some more concepts, don't worry, but let's take this question. Yes, students, quickly, quickly in a moment. यस साई करण, करेक्ट आंसर. साई करण, वेरी करेक्ट आंसर. ओके, सो फिगर शोज अ रिपल काउंटर. वेरी सिंपल गेट क्वेश्चन. फिगर शोज अ रिपल काउंटर यूजिंग पॉजिटिव एज ट्रिगर्ड फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स, एंड इफ द प्रेजेंट स्टेट ऑफ द काउंटर इज गिवन टू यू एज 011, व्हाट इज द नेक्स्ट स्टेट. सो कैन यू आइडेंटिफाई व्हाट इज द टाइप ऑफ काउंटर इट इज. क्यू बार टू पॉजिटिव एज. क्यू बार टू पॉजिटिव एज. कैन यू आइडेंटिफाई द टाइप ऑफ काउंटर. आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन. सी वॉट यू हैव टू रिमेंबर, यू डोंट रिमेंबर ऑल द फोर पॉइंट्स. यू डोंट रिमेंबर ऑल द फोर पॉइंट्स, यू जस्ट रिमेंबर वन पॉइंट. वॉट वी हैव डिराइव्ड, वॉट वी हैव सॉल्व, क्यू टू नेगेटिव एज, दैट इज वॉट वी हैव सॉल्व. रिमेंबर दैट ओनली. ठीक है, एंड देन इफ आई चेंज क्यू टू क्यू बार, इफ आई चेंज क्यू टू क्यू बार, एंड इफ दिस इज नेगेटिव एज ओनली, if this is negative edge only, it becomes down. But what is given here? Q bar to positive edge. They have taken Q bar to positive edge. So what it should be? It should be an up counter. Okay. So you only have to remember this point which I have derived. Okay. Which we have solved. Q to negative edge. Clear everyone? Okay. And isi ko modify karke form the other combinations. That's simple. Okay. So if it is an up counter, what comes after 3? 011 means 3. And what comes after 3? It should be 4. And 4 matlab 100. A simple one mark. It's a 2 mark question, but it's a simple like 1 mark question only. Okay, so you just have to identify. You don't have to solve this question now. Identify what is the clock connection to Q. ठीक है, and if it is up counter, 3 के बाद 4 आएगा. If it had been down counter, then 3 के पहले 3 के बाद 2 होता. ठीक है, but right now it is a up counter. Clear, clear, clear everyone? Yes, B is the correct answer. B is the correct answer. Yes, fine. Yes, fine. Yes, number 4. 4 means you have answered in binary 100. Correct. Now, next question. The next question. Asynchronous counter shown below is mod dash. Now, what do you mean by mod? I'll explain you. Okay, this is not visible. Now, I'll make it visible. What is mod? Mod number of a counter means the number of states of a counter. Number of states of a counter. Now, this is a very important question coming up from the ripple counter, from the asynchronous counter. Mod matlab, remember, mod matlab, number of states of a counter is known as mod counter. Okay? Jamal, how it's Q bar? See, you can see in the question, the clock connection has been derived from Q bar. Q bar. Yes. So, that is why I have taken Q bar. Is this clear to Jamal? Okay. Yeah, Ram Yadav, you're asking a valid doubt, sir. If it is T flip-flop, see, what was my discussion? Okay, I'll make this clear to everyone. Do not worry. What was my discussion? In my discussion, both J and K were equal to 1, and JK equal to 1 ultimately means what? Toggle. Okay. And what is T equal to 1? It also means toggle. So you can design the ripple counter either by both JK equal to 1 or either by using T equal to 1. Either by using T equal to 1. So come back to the question. See, what are all the T inputs? 1, 1, 1. Similarly, now come to this question. What they have specified, this is a gate question. This is again by using JK inputs, and they have asked you to assume all the JK inputs to be high. They have not written, but all the JK inputs will be high. Okay? Okay, Mr. Ram? Yes. So both JK 1 or T equal to 1. That is important to note. Chaliye. Now let's solve this. Can you please tell me what is this flip-flop? Clock is in the ripple counter. I've clearly told you clock is only applied to the LSB. So this should be LSB. So I will make it as Q naught. And this should be MSB. I'll make it as Q4. Q0, Q1, Q2, Q3 and Q4. Clear to everyone? Yes. So, first of all, I'll explain you what is this reset. There's a reset coming up here. And I'll explain you with the question only. Okay, yehi maine aapko beginning mein bola tha. Mostly with questions, I'll explain you some small concept rather than taking the theory. So, see here. First, identify the type of connection. It is Q2. Q2 what? Q2 negative edge. See, this is Q and this is negative. All the connections are same only. So Q2 negative edge. I'm seeing your answers as mod 5, mod 5, mod 5. No, answers is not equal to mod 5. Please recheck. Answer is not equal to mod 5. Answer is not equal to mod 5. Oh, maybe you have taken mod 5 because you have not taken care of MSB, LSB. Okay, you are reading it reverse manner. Okay, that is why you're getting as mod 5. Okay, so maybe you have solved correct, but you have read the data incorrectly. Clock is only applied to LSB. Clock is only applied to LSB. So this is LSB and this is MSB. So you have to count from MSB to LSB. Now correct your answers. Chaliye. So Q2 negative edge. Tell me what is the type of counter? Isn't it up? The same type of discussions we have already had. It is up counter. Q2 negative edge. It's up counter. Theek hai? So because it's up counter, what will be the count sequence? See clearly everyone with me, I'm writing the count sequence. Q4, Q3, Q2, Q1 and Q0. Because it is up counter, so I will start with 00000, next 00001, next will 00010. You know how to count in binary, we have done with the number system. And etc, 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 it will keep on increasing in the up manner. In the up manner. But where to stop? How to count the count sequence? See, if there is no reset like this, if there is no reset like this, so definitely it will count to what? It will count to the last 8, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and then again go back to 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. That is what it will do. But right now, you have to look into the reset. Now, what is the role of reset? First of all, I'll make you explain that this bubble matlab active low. So when you get low signal here, when you get low signal, zero means low signal, the flip-flop will reset. All the flip-flops will be reset. And from where this output is derived? It is derived from the NAND gate. The inputs of NAND gate are, carefully see, Q2 and Q4. What are the inputs of the NAND gate? Q2 and Q4. Okay. So please keep a track of this. Q2 and Q4. So, the output of NAND gate is given by Q4, Q2 whole bar. And this we want this output to be 0. Because when the NAND gate gives 0 output, all the flip-flops will be reset. That is the role of reset pin. All the flip-flops will be reset. So, Q4, Q2 bar will be 0 when? If both Q2 and Q2 are equal. Q4 and Q2 are equal to 1. Okay. So, you have to wait until both Q4 and Q2 becomes 1. Okay, so first I make Q4 1 and all other zeros. That means in decimal, if I write, this is 16. Okay, let me write in decimal. This is 0, this is 1, this is 2. Okay, after 16, you get 17. So it will keep on increasing. Now you have to wait for what? You have to wait for this 1. For this 1 to become high. Okay, so let this to be 0. So 10100. See, what is 100? You know in binary, what is 100? 4. So 16 plus 4. This is 20. Okay, 16 plus 4 and 20. I have missed some numbers in between. I have directly taken this one. ठीक है, तो 10100 एंड व्हेन यू कम टू द स्टेट 10100 द नैंड गेट आउटपुट बिकम जीरो एंड व्हेन द नैंड गेट आउटपुट बिकम जीरो व्हाट विल हैपन इमीडिएटली, ठीक है, इमीडिएटली ऑल द फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स आर रीसेट, रीसेट मतलब 0000, सो इमीडिएटली दिस स्टेट डज नॉट एग्जिस्ट and immediately all the flip flops are reset whenever the output of the NAND gate, because NAND gate will have a negligible delay in front of flip flop, so whenever the NAND gate output is zero, immediately all the flip flops are reset, all the flip flops are reset and you go back where, you go back to the initial state, and because you go back to the initial state, what is my count sequence? See, my count sequence is actually 0 1 2 etc up to what? Up to 19. See, do not count 20 because 20 will come and go away. It will not exist for one clock cycle. 20 will come and go away immediately. And because it goes away immediately, after 19, what is the next state that I am seeing is 0. Next state I am seeing is 0. So what is the total number of states? If you count from decimal 0 to 19, it is mod 20. It is a mod 20 counter. Okay, Minitube, nice explanation. Yeah, thank you. And even others, if you're liking the explanation, if you're liking the video, do not miss to hit the like button. Okay, it's a motivation for everyone, for all the community and for every one of you. Okay, so answer is mod 20. Okay, answer is mod 20 counter. Is this clear to everyone? Yes, the very important question, including ripple counter with reset. But you have to remember, I have not solved the ripple counter. I have just used this method. Connection, Q to negative edge, it is up counter. So do not solve the counter. Up or down, identify kar lije. Up or down, identify kar lije. Do not count. You just have to see when the reset is activated. And this, again I repeat, this bubble represents active low. This bubble represents active low. Okay, my dear students. So the answer is mod 20 for this question. Answer is mod 20 for this question. Okay. Yes, thank you, Mahmuda, and thank you, everyone. I hope your concepts are getting clear. Okay, now I shall go for a next question. Okay, so we have taken two ripple counter questions as of now. Okay. Yes, next question. What are the counting stages Q1, Q2 for this counter shown below? Counting stages for this counter shown below. Now, please see that. What is the type of counter? Please comment what is the type of this counter. Can you comment? Whether it is synchronous or ripple. See, clock goes where? On to Q1 and as well as on to Q2. The same clock goes here. So that means this question is based on synchronous counter. Based on synchronous counter. Okay. Srinivasan sir, why you take Q4 and Q2? Why you take Q4 and Q2? You have to see. NAND gate inputs. This is Q2 and this is Q4. Whatever connection is given in the question, I have taken that only. Okay, Srinivasan? Yeah. So this is a synchronous question. See, I have specifically taken some questions of gate of that level, which will help you in NILIT, which will help you very much in NILIT. Okay. So let's solve this question and come up with the answer. Come up with an answer for this question. Yes. Yes. So please do not use the Q2 negative edge or Q2 positive edge trick here. It is not a ripple counter. Those Q2 negative and Q2 positive edge is for ripple counter. This is a synchronous counter. You have to solve. Okay. You know what is a JK flip flop. You have to solve it actually. Okay. I'm waiting for you. Kindly solve. Okay, students, yes, let's come up with the answer. Let's come up. I'll write down the counting sequence here, Q1 and Q2. I will start writing the counting sequence Q1 and Q2. Please look at this. Please look at this. See what is happening. First, you note the connections. Okay, what is for the second flip-flop? What is the value of J2? It is coming from Q1 bar. Is it visible to everyone? It is coming from Q1 bar. And what is the value for K2? K2 is fixed at 1. Now, K2 is fixed at 1. Okay. Now, what is the connection? Always rocks. A, absolutely correct. Very good. Very good. Yes. Now, what is the J1 and K1 connection? They are coming from a single line. J1 and K1 are both same. And same, they are coming from where? From coming from Q2 bar. From Q2 bar. Okay. Yeah, students, if you want more such live classes, please hit the like button. The more you like, the more we get motivated to put on videos for you. Okay. The whole Grade Up team and myself will try best and best to try to give you more and more content. So do not miss to hit the like button. Okay, Q1, Q2. What I have already told you, ki start by reset. Start by reset. Both flip-flop 0, 0. Okay. And if I start by reset, I will again write down those connections here. See what I've written here. J2 is Q1 bar. J2 is Q1 bar. And K2 is fixed as 1. Okay. What is J1 and K1? They are both coming from Q2 bar. They are both coming from Q2 bar. Yes, Raghav, A. Charit, mostly one or two calculations. If you do, you will get to the options. Yes. Okay. But at least one or two questions you have to do. Okay. No, I don't think, Monica, this is time consuming. This is very easy. You don't have to apply the characteristic equation. You just have to remember what does J and K flip-flop works. Okay. So come on. Come up with me. I'm going to solve. 0, 0 is the initial state. First, let's solve for Q1. So what, for Q1, you have to see what is J1, K1. J1, K1 is Q2 bar. What is Q2 right now? 0. 0 complement. 1. J and K both 1. J and K both 1. Matlab toggle. So just toggle Q1. Clear? Go with this process. Now, what is J2 Q1 bar? What is the Q1? See, don't take this value. What is this? Unless and until you get the next state completely. Okay, this is the upcoming state. Right now, I have only written in my tab. In your notebook, you are writing. But this will, both will come at the same time because it is synchronous. Both will come at the same time. So, what is the value of Q1 that you will use here? Okay, the current 0. This is the next. So, what is 0 complement? 1. K2 is 1. J2, K2, 1. Toggle. J2, K2, J or K1. Toggle. So Q2 also toggle. Now next state is 1 1. After 1 1, what will I do? See, to look at J1 K1, it is Q2 bar. What is the value of Q2 now? 1 1 complement 0. J1 K1 0. J1 K1 0. Same state. So Q1 does not change. Q1 is in the same state. Clear, everyone? Okay. Now J2 is Q1 bar. What is Q1? Take this value of Q1. This value of Q1. 1 1 complement 0. J0 K1. J0 K1. Is reset. I've already told J0 K1 means reset. So I've reset this flip-flop, Q2 flip-flop. Clear, everyone? So this is 1 0. Okay, this is 1 0. See, are you able to mark the options after 1 1 1 0? See, after 1 1 1 0, okay, after 1 1 1 0, only option A matches. After 1 1 1 0, it should be there, only option A matches. Okay, so by the option verification, you need to do only this much. For the option verification, you only need to do this much. But I'll solve it completely. One more calculation. I'll solve it completely. But for the option, it is selected. Chaliye. Now, again, J1, K1 is Q2 bar. What is Q2? 0. 0 complement 1. So J or K, 1. Toggle. Toggle this. Now, look at J2. J2 is Q1 bar. What is Q1? Q1 means this current value. Don't take the next value of Q1. So Q1 current value 1. 1 complement 0. So again J0 K1. J0 K1 matlab reset Q2. So you got 0 0. Matlab repetition. And when you have to solve? When you have, up to when you have to solve? When you get repetition. So 0 0, 1 1, 1 0 and then back to 0 0. So option 1, option A, 1 1, 1 0 and 0 0. Then 1 1, 1 0 etc. Okay, but at least to satisfy the options, you know, directly only this calculation was enough. Yes, so option A is the correct option. Option A is the correct option. Okay. Yeah, Mahmuda, can you specify the doubt? Okay, where you are stuck? Where you are stuck? See, what I've only done, I'll repeat in brief. I've taken the initial state as 0, 0. And I've just written the J and K input. Look at this. I have just written the J and K input function. Okay, whatever is the value of Q1 and Q2 available, accordingly I am making the J or K input. Accordingly I am making the J or K input. And then I have already told if J0, K1, it is reset. If J equal to K equal to 1 is coming, it is toggle. Okay, so like that I am taking the value for, changing the state. या श्री चक्रम, यू कैन अप्लाई दिस मेथड फॉर एनी एग्जाम. ठीक है, यू जस्ट नीड प्रैक्टिस. मे बी इफ यू आर यू नो सॉल्विंग दिस फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम, इट माइट बी लिटिल यू नो टाइम कंज्यूमिंग, बट डू नॉट वरी. डू नॉट मेक अ कंप्लीट स्टेट टेबल वेर यू राइट करेंट स्टेट एंड नेक्स्ट स्टेट. विद इन वन स्टेट ओनली आई एम सॉल्विंग, आई एम ट्राइंग टू सेव टाइम ओनली. ठीक है, वॉट यू ओनली नीड इज प्रैक्टिस. प्रैक्टिस भी कैसा, आपको माइंड में यू नो जब क्लिक हो जाएगा ना, J0K1 रीसेट, J1K0 सेट, J1K1 टॉगल, J0K0 सेम. See, because I am into practice, I know very quickly. Okay, when you also get into practice, when you also go into practice, it will be very easy. Okay, instantly mind mein click ho jana chahiye, J0K1 reset. Okay, time kahan lagega, sochne mein lagega. So when you solve more and more question, this will be eliminated. Okay, so this becomes a very fast method once you have the practice of all the flip-flops. Okay, according to me, it becomes a very fast method. Yeah, so option number A has been identified as correct for this. Okay? Fine? Yes. Come on. Now to this question, Annihilate 2018 Scientist B question. Very simple. Very, very simple. Very, very simple question. Yeah, I'm expecting answers from everyone for this. I'm expecting answers for everyone from this. A very simple question. Yeah, Mahmuda, I have told the procedure. Just what I am telling you is, start with, I'll repeat this again. Start the procedure by 00 and for every state, calculate the JK input and then use your knowledge of the JK key for what JK, what happens. J1K0 set, J0K1 reset and etc. and write down the next state. With practice, this method becomes absolutely the best method. Okay? Clear to everyone? Kindly comment on the previous question, the JK flip-flop question. That's a very good question. If you're able to solve such question of counter, I'll tell you, please mind everyone, if you're able to solve such question of counter, then all type of question of counter will become, you know, little handy for you. Okay? Little handy for you. Yes. Yes. A very simple nihilist question. Okay, I'll solve this. The present output Qn of an H triggered JK flip-flop is at logic 0. And if J is equal to 1, what is Qn plus 1? They are asking what is Qn plus 1? Matlab next state. Now only they have given the value of J. They have not given the value of K. Is it a problem? Can you solve without the value of K? Yes, you can solve without the value of K. Yes, Shrikant, Raghav, Mahmuda, Dorothy Berman, Anjali, Pritesh, everyone correct answer C. Yes, it will be at logic 1. C. I'll tell you what. If J is 1, means what is the value of K they have given? Unknown. Okay. K is don't care. They have not given. So I can take both the values of K. So I can take two cases, J1 or K0. C. Now that's what should be my practice. J1, K0 means what? Set state. Always rocks. No, A is not the correct answer. It can be determined. J1, K0 is set. Or because K is not given, I can take K equal to 1 and J1, K1 means what? Toggle. Now, according to the set condition, what is my next state? Set 1. According to the toggle condition, what is Qn plus 1? It is toggle of Qn. But what is Qn given to you? What is Qn given to you? 0. So what is the toggle? What is the toggle for 0 is 1. So in either case, what is my answer? In either case, my answer will be 1. So I do not need the value of K. If J equal to 1 and Qn equal to 0, Qn plus will be 1. Qn plus 1 will be equal to 1. Is this clear to everyone? It's a very simple question. Very, very, very simple question. Yes? Okay. Also, if you want, you can solve it by the characteristic equation of JK. What is the characteristic equation I have told you? JQ bar plus K bar Q. Okay. This also you can use directly. Characteristic equation of JK flip-flop, JQ bar plus K bar Q. Okay, so see, Q is 0. Okay, so this part is gone. That is why I don't need the value of K bar, because Q is 0. Q 0, Q bar 1, J is given to as 1. 1 into 1, Q plus is 1. Solved. This is also a one-line answer. This is also a one-line answer. Clear, everyone? Okay, so both methods are very, very simple. Okay, and I'm giving you the next question. Now see, Nihilate. Two times they've asked you a very simple ripple counter question, just theoretical ripple counter question. ठीक है, इन अ रिपल काउंटर यूजिंग एच ट्रिगर जेके फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स द पल्स इनपुट इज अप्लाइड वेयर, द पल्स इनपुट इज अप्लाइड वेयर, ठीक है, इज इट अप्लाइड टू क्लॉक इनपुट ऑफ ऑल द फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स, इफ यू अप्लाई द क्लॉक टू ऑल द फ्लिप फ्लॉप्स इट बिकम्स व्हाट, इट बिकम्स सिंक्रोनस एक्चुअली, ठीक है, इज इट अप्लाइड टू जे एंड के इनपुट ऑफ वन फ्लिप फ्लॉप और ऑल फ्लिप फ्लॉप, नो इट इज नॉट अप्लाइड टू द जे के इनपुट बाय द वे, जे के फॉर द रिपल काउंटर, है ना, प्लीज डू नॉट फॉरगेट फॉर द रिपल काउंटर जे एंड के आर बोथ वन, दे आर फिक्स्ड एट वन, दे आर नॉट डिराइव्ड, ओके, what has happened, it is applied to the clock of one flip flop, and what is that one flip flop, that also I have told you LSB, so option number D, two times I have asked you this question, theek hai, two times I have asked you this question, yes D is the correct answer, theek hai, D is the correct answer, Sunil I am really sorry I will not be having that much of time because it's just around 1 hour session, so please kindly ask me these doubt on the GradeUp app, I will come up with an explanation of JK flip flop. ठीक है, और एल्स यू नो वी विल बी लॉन्चिंग नाइलिट कोर्सेज, वी विल बी लॉन्चिंग गेट कोर्सेज, व्हेन यू रेफर टू द गेट कोर्सेज ऑल द न्यू कोर्सेज इन्फॉर्मेशन विल बी अवेलेबल ऑन द GradeUp ऐप, वेदर इट इज नाइलिट और गेट कोर्स, सो व्हेन यू गो एंड जॉइन अवर कंप्लीट कोर्सेज देयर यू विल हैव ऑल डिस्कशंस, ऑल ईच एंड एवरी सिंगल टॉपिक डिस्कशन विल बी देयर, ओके, ठीक है, तो डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर, सिंपल डायरेक्ट क्वेश्चन दैट इज आस्क्ड, ओके, आई विल टेक अप दिस काउंटर, yeah, first let's solve this question, and I'm taking a mixture of question, first let's solve this question, in a JK flip-flop, J is connected to Q bar and K is connected to Q output, what is the JK flip-flop converted to, Nilit 2017 question. Yeah, Charit, definitely we are trying to start the complete Nilit course very soon. For further inquiries, you can directly go to the app, or you have contact numbers given on our website. You can contact to our team. They will reply you with much more details about the course. Yeah, in the JK flip-flop, J is connected to Q bar and K is connected to Q. The JK flip-flop is converted to what? No, Sunil, RS is not the correct answer. Kanchan, Shikhar and Pratyusha. Neeraj, Arun. No, Arun, it's not the correct answer. C is the correct answer. Others are giving. Yes, mini tube, toggle counter. Yes, T flip-flop, it's actually the correct answer. So, see, in a JK flip-flop, J is connected to Q bar. Okay, so Q bar is taken and connected to J. And K is connected with the Q output. Okay, so this is taken. And this is connected to K. This JK flip-flop is now converted to. So I will solve this in one line by taking the characteristic equation of JK. What is the characteristic equation of JK? It is JQ bar plus K bar Q. Now, what is coming to J? It is Q bar only. So it is Q bar into Q bar plus K. Now, what is coming to K? It is directly Q. Okay, so K bar means Q bar. K is actually equal to Q. And J is equal to Q bar and K is equal to Q. So K is substituted as Q. What is Q bar into Q in Boolean? What is Q bar into Q bar? Q bar. X into X is X. What is Q bar into Q? X bar into X is 0. So you get the conclusion that Q plus is Q bar. That means the state is just toggled. And the state is toggled means T flip-flop. The state is toggled when it is T flip-flop. Okay. It is T flip-flop. The option number C is absolutely correct. Option number C is absolutely correct. Yes, is this clear up to this point, students? Yes. So these are some 2-3 very simple questions of Nilit. As you have seen, very, very basic questions they are asking in Nilit. And before I go to next question, I am again going back to the theory section. Okay. Some important discussions. Okay. Some important discussions. Okay. Okay. Follow everyone. Again, going back to the theory section. We have designed both a synchronous counter and a ripple counter. Both we have designed. Both we have designed as up counter. Means 000 to 111. 000 to 111. Now, look at this. The count sequence is 000. I am writing here again. 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 001, 01001110110111111, and after 111 again 000. That is the count sequence that we have derived. Okay, and I am specifically going to take the MSB waveform, MSB waveform Q2. See, if I start, please note that if I start by this state 111, if I start by the state 111, what is the state, what is the value of Q2 here? What is the value of Q2? It is 1. Okay. And then when the clock edge arrives, what happens? We go to the state 000. And see, in the state 000, what is MSB? See, now in the upcoming four states, the MSB is 0. Okay. So this will be 0. Again, on the next clock Q2, I am only sketching MSB. Again, on the next clock, MSB will be 0. And again, on the next clock, MSB is 0. Because for the four states, MSB is 0. Then when the next clock comes, what is the MSB? Now it is going to become 1, and it remains 1 for 4 more clock cycles. It remains 1 for 4 more clock cycles. Okay, so this is 1 after next clock, 1, 1, 1. For 4 clock cycles, it is 1. For 4 clock cycles, it is 1. So for 4 clock cycles, it is 0, and for 4 clock cycles, it is 1. Okay, now 1, 2, 0. 1, 2, 0. Now, this is the point of repetition. And I'm trying to find the time period of the Q2 waveform, time period of the MSB waveform. Okay. So, see, what is the time period? So, what is this? I refer to this as one time period of the clock. Time period means what? The time for repetition. Okay. So, this is my first positive edge. This is my next positive edge. So, this is known as the time period of this waveform. I refer this time period as T clock, time period of clock. Okay. So, one, second time period, third time period, fourth, five, six, seven, eight. How many clock time periods are consumed? Eight. So what is TQ2? Is 8 T clock. What is TQ2? Is 8 T clock. So what is FQ2? What is FQ2? It is 1 by 8. Because what is the relation between frequency and time period? Frequency is 1 upon time period. So if time period is 8 T clock, frequency is converted to 1 by 8 F clock. Now, this is important. Known as the concept of frequency division in counter. What is the frequency out of the at the output of any counter where I've taken the output at MSB? Okay, please remember this result. Frequency at MSB is equal to the applied clock frequency divided by N. Here I've written 1 by N times the clock frequency, where N represents the mod number. See, the counter we have designed was 000 to 111. How many states? 8, na? So it is a mod 8 counter. Already I've defined what is mod number. Already I've defined to you know what is mod number. It was mod 8. Okay. So that is why the frequency is divided here. The frequency is divided by 8 because 8 is the mod number. So whatever be the mod number, the frequency of MSB is clock frequency divided by N. So this is a very important frequency division concept. Okay, very important frequency division concept. Please take a screenshot, or you can again refer to the video later on. But this is important. Frequency at MSB as clock frequency divided by N. That is why counters also behave as frequency division circuits. Counters are also known as frequency division circuits. Clear? Now I'm taking up a question on this concept. The Nilet question, I'm taking up a question on this concept. What is the frequency at the point C in the circuit? Okay, so I'll tell you this again. I am in this session, I do not have time to cover details of ring counter. Okay, if possible, okay, if you demand much more, we can take up separate sessions on ring counter and Johnson counter. But right now, ring counter, I will tell you, if it is a n bit ring counter, it is mod number equal to n. For Johnson counter, but if you have already studied for gate, then you must be knowing this. If Johnson is a n bit Johnson counter, its mod number will be actually 2n. Okay, so what is the frequency at point C in this circuit? That is what you have to derive. Frequency at point C is what you have to derive here. Okay, आपके लिए. सो व्हाट इज द फ्रीक्वेंसी एट ए, व्हाट इज द अप्लाइड फ्रीक्वेंसी टू द फर्स्ट काउंटर, व्हाट इज द अप्लाइड फ्रीक्वेंसी टू द अप काउंटर. शशिधर व्हाट अबाउट एलएसबी? यस I'll tell you, I'll give you a brief hint. Later on, you can ask me more doubts. Ki MSB is divide by N, that is divide by N, matlab divide by actually 2 raised to the power number of flip-flop. And as you go lower, it keeps on dividing by 2 raised to the power N minus 1, 2 raised to the power N minus 2. And when you come to LSB, it is actually divide by 2. Okay, Shashidhar? So it will be divide by 2 for a regular binary up counter. Okay, so because the first counter given here is a ring counter, what is the A frequency? It is the applied frequency, that is 10 megahertz divided by, because it is 10 bit ring counter, what will be the mod number? I've already given you the formula for ring counter. The mod number will also be N, matlab 10. So the A frequency is 1 megahertz. The A frequency is 1 megahertz. Okay. Now here, I'm taking here, B frequency. B frequency will be A frequency divided by mod number. Now what is the A frequency? 1 megahertz. It is divided by 4-bit Johnson counter mod number will be how much? 2N, that is 8. So 1 megahertz divided by 8, 1000 divided by 8, if you do, you get 125 kilohertz. This is the answer for B. And then C. And then C. What is C? The C frequency will be B frequency divided by mod number again. And mod number matlab N3 for the third device. Let me write this as N2. What is the B frequency? 125 kilohertz. And the third device is directly given to you as some mod 10 ripple counter. So it is given as mod 10. So just divide by 10. Just divide by 10. And the answer is 12.5 kilohertz. Option number B. Choose option number B. Yes, Shikhar, 12.5 is correct. Mahmuda, 10 is not correct. The answer is 12.5. What you have to divide? Just divide the mod number of a respective counter to get the output frequency. To get the output frequency. By output, I mean the MSB bit actually. Okay? Yeah, Shashidhar, Vivek, B, absolutely correct answer. Yes, 12.5 kilohertz is the correct answer. Is this frequency division concept clear to everyone or not? Is this frequency division concept clear to everyone? Yes. Okay, fine. I know the time has been extended, but I'm trying to take one or two more questions if you are interested. So guys, no problem in going further. 5-10 minutes. I'll take up one or two more questions helpful for you. Just I have put one question. Very, very, very simple. What they have termed one time, they have just asked you the characteristic equation of the T flip-flop. And I've already told you the characteristic equation of T flip-flop. It is T XOR Q. That means T Q bar plus T bar Q. Only thing is, they have made both the A and B options as same. Just rearrange. So both A and B options are correct. T Q bar plus T bar Q. Okay. So see, sometimes you directly get Mahmuda ripple equal to ring counter. No. Ring counter is totally different. Okay. Ring counter is totally different. Okay. So I am not taking details of ring counter, but yes, at least I'll reply you. It is not ripple counter. Okay. So see, sometimes they are asking you very direct question. Tell me the characteristic equation of a flip-flop. So answer is in front of you. Both A and B are just matching. They have given the same data for A and B. Clear everyone? Okay. Okay, I'll take this question first now. Yeah, everyone expecting you to solve this question. So with this question, ultimately, we are also going to understand the simple operation of a shift register. Now, the simple operation of a shift register. Yes. With this, I am explaining the simple operation for shift register. Blessy Thomas. Yeah, if you have studied well for gate, and then if you go to all previous gate questions and as well as previous NILET question. Okay, whatever exam you are focusing, that previous questions you must necessarily do. The previous gate questions, previous NILET question, assuming that you have studied well, you have the notes of gate, it is sufficient. Okay, don't you have to go, you have to worry about any other notes at least. Okay. Yeah, Mahmuda, in the last question, C was a ripple, the internal design was not given, but you have to only see the mod number. They have directly given some ripple counter, mod 10 ripple counter. ठीक है तो यू हैव टू यूज द मॉड नंबर ओनली ना इन द फ्रीक्वेंसी डिवीजन. चलिए सो नाउ वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड द ऑपरेशन ऑफ दिस शिफ्ट रजिस्टर. Okay. So let's start considering this question now, and how does a shift register work? That theory will also be clear here to everyone. Okay, so see, please look at the connection. All the D flip-flop output, see, this is QA, it is already written here, goes to the D flip-flop of the next input. So A, B, C, D is the flip-flops they are taking. So now, with respect to D flip-flop, I will tell you, with respect to D flip-flop, Shikhar, yes, you are already coming up with the correct answer. What is the characteristic equation of a D flip-flop? Q plus equal to D. That means whatever is the D input, that becomes the next state Q plus. Q plus equal to D. So can you please see what is QB plus? What is QB plus? Will be equal to DB, the D input. Q plus equal to T. But what is coming to the D input of B flip-flop? It is QA. It is QA. Then similarly, what is QC plus? QC plus is DC. But what is coming to DC? What is coming to DC? It is equal to QB. Okay. And what is QD plus will be equal to DD. Okay. This I refer to as DD. And what is coming to DD is QC. That means what? The current value of QA goes to QB plus, next value of QB. The current value of QB goes to QC plus. The current value of QB goes to QC plus, right? Right? Are you able to see? Okay. So QC plus. Then the current value of QC goes to QD plus. Matlab, this current value is going to transfer here on the next clock. That means what is happening? What is happening? The content of every flip-flop is passed on right. Passed on one bit right. Then what comes to the MSB? What is only left is MSB. In this shift register, I call this input pin as SI. This input pin as SI, known as serial input. Serial input, and this input is actually in this question, it can be derived by any method. In this question, they have taken the serial input. I will write here. They have taken the serial input as the XOR of QC and QD. As the XOR of QC and QC. Are you able to see this? Yes, this XOR goes to SI. And then what is QA plus? Okay, is equal to DA. Q plus equal to D for every D flip-flop. So what is QA plus is DA, and what is coming to DA? Is the serial input, and that is the XOR of QC and QD. ठीक है, so how will I solve this question? How will I solve this question? To see the operation very, very carefully. QA, QB, QC, QD. QA, QB, QC, QD. ठीक है, now first, some possibilities are given here. ठीक है, the expected sequence of output at QD, QC, QB, QA can be. ठीक है, QD, QC, QA, QB can be. ठीक है, what is the expected sequence of output? So here they have given you some options. ठीक है, we just have to verify. I understood the operation. Now you can start solving. Now you can start solving. Okay, come on. So now please note that the expected sequence of output is actually what they are specifying. The sequence is QD, QC, QB, QA. So whatever the data according to them is given, it is QD, QC, QB, QA. ठीक है, but I am writing as QA, QB, QC, QD. I will just reverse. I will just reverse it as 1000. So what will be my next state? So see what I have told. 100 is shifted right. The flip-flop, every flip-flop output is shifted right. What comes here? It is the XOR of QC and QD. See, 00, same. Same ka XOR, 0. So next should be 0100. Okay, reverse, correct. You have to read reverse, 0100. Okay, now next. 010 is transferred right. The first three bits are transferred right, one by one. And then 00 XOR, 00 XOR is still 0. Okay, so 0010, correct? Yes, 0010. Here I am reading reverse. Here I am reading reverse. A, B, C, D. Okay. Now next. 001 is transferred here. 1 and 0 ka XOR. What is 0? XOR of 1 and 0, it is different. So answer is 1. So next state is 1001. No, it does not match. No, it does not match. According to them, it is 1000. Okay. So it is 1001. So first possibility is not correct. Clear? First possibility is not correct. Second one. Okay, second one. Start from here, 1100. Start from here, 1100. 1100. Is the operation of shift register clear? Please comment. ठीक है, 1100 means 110. ना फर्स्ट थ्री बिट्स आर शिफ्टेड राइट. व्हाट इज द एक्सओआर ऑफ 00? 0. सेम पे 0. तो 0110, 0110. आर यू गेटिंग दिस? नो. ठीक है, इट शुड बी 0110 एंड आई एम नॉट गेटिंग दैट. क्लियर? आई एम नॉट गेटिंग दैट. फाइन, आई एम नॉट गेटिंग दैट. ठीक है, तो प्लीज नोट द सीक्वेंस. दे हैव डिस्टर्ब द सीक्वेंस. दे हैव गिवन क्यूडी क्यूसी क्यूबी की है. इट इज क्लियरली गिवन स्पेसिफाइड इन द क्वेश्चन. थर्ड वन. ठीक है, थर्ड वन. अच्छा, फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड आर नॉट करेक्ट. विद दिस कैन आई मार्क द ऑप्शन? ठीक है, सेकंड इज कमिंग एवरीवेयर. सेकंड इज कमिंग एवरीवेयर. ठीक है, सो सेकंड इट इज नॉट करेक्ट. ठीक है, सो कैन आई मार्क द ऑप्शन? यस, नन ऑफ द ऑप्शन शुड बी करेक्ट बिकॉज सेकंड इज देयर इन एवरी ऑप्शन. ठीक है, बट लेट्स चेक द थर्ड वन. वॉट इज द थर्ड वन? 0111. रिवर्स यू हैव टू रीड 0111. ठीक है, तो नाउ फर्स्ट थ्री बिट शिफ्टेड राइट. 0111, 1 and 1 का एक्सॉर 0. ठीक है, तो 0011. नो, हेयर ऑल्सो इट डज नॉट मैच. सो नन ऑफ द ऑप्शन इज एक्चुअली करेक्ट. नन ऑफ द ऑप्शन इज एक्चुअली करेक्ट. सी, आई टेल यू, मोस्ट ऑफ यू आर गेटिंग बी. Most of you are getting B. Your calculations are correct, but why your answer is not correct? Because you have taken this as A, B, C, D. But read the question. Read the question. They are telling that their sequence is D, C, B, A. ठीक है, तो D, C, B, A. And if you are solving A, B, C, D, just reverse their sequence. उनका sequence reverse कर दीजिए. Yes, Vivek, D is the correct answer. So I clearly tell everyone, whenever you have got B, your calculations might be correct. I am assuming your calculations might be correct. Only difference is your sequence. Your sequence you have taken as A, B, C, D. ठीक है, अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट इट इज करेक्ट बी, बट दैट इज नॉट एक्चुअली द करेक्ट आंसर ना, बिकॉज यू हैव टू रीड द सीक्वेंस एज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. एज गिवन इन द क्वेश्चन. इज दैट क्लियर टू एवरी वन? इज दैट क्लियर टू एवरी वन? या, बट वन मोर थिंग, वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. इफ आई डोंट गिव यू एनी सीक्वेंस देन, इफ आई डोंट गिव यू एनी सीक्वेंस देन, ऑलवेज इफ आई डोंट गिव यू एनी सीक्वेंस देन राइट डाउन द सीक्वेंस फ्रॉम MSB टू LSB. दैट यू कैन डू. ठीक है, इफ इट इज नॉट गिवन राइट डाउन फ्रॉम MSB टू LSB. हाउ वी राइट अ नंबर? वी हैव स्टडीड नंबर सिस्टम ना. फर्स्ट MSB एंड देन वी राइट डाउन द नंबर टू LSB. ठीक है, दैट इज व्हाट यू कैन डू. क्लियर? यस विवेक, अदिति, डी इज द करेक्ट आंसर फॉर यू. फॉर ऑल दोज हू हैव गॉट बी, अगेन आई से योर कैलकुलेशंस माइट बी करेक्ट, बट ओनली थिंग योर सीक्वेंस वॉज डिफरेंट. क्लियर एवरीवन? या, यस. सो दिस क्वेश्चन फाइनली आई एम कमिंग अप with homework. ठीक है, this question, nihilit question is a homework for you. ठीक है, I'll tell you, this is based on ripple counter with the reset. Instead of reset, they have used the word clear. ठीक है, if you remember, we have solved one question. If you have solved one question, Anjali, see, in the case of shift register, MSB is the point where serial input enters. That is how you can say for shift register. For different types of counters, it is different method. But for shift register, Anjali, it will be serial input where the external input is coming. Okay? Where is the external input coming? That is serial input and that is referred as MSB for shift register. Okay, please remember this point, everyone. Okay, so a simple homework I am giving to you. Okay, so you remember one question of gate we have solved where reset pin was used. Instead of reset, they have used the word clear. Clear. ठीक है, तो clear means same as reset. ठीक है, तो what is there going to the NAND gate? They have not given you the diagram, but they have directly taken a statement. You have to crack the statement and write down this answer. ठीक है, it is. I'll give you the answers, or shall I expect the answers from you? अच्छा गाइज, वन वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इन्फॉर्मेशन कि इफ यू वॉन्ट फर्दर क्वेश्चन, सी बिकॉज आई हैव ऑलरेडी क्रॉस्ड इट्स 1.5 hours इंस्टेड ऑफ 1 hour सेशन, बट इफ यू फील लाइक यू वॉन्ट मोर ऑफ दीज, प्लीज ड्रॉप मी अ मेल और प्लीज रिप्लाई टू द ग्रेट अप ऐप. आई विल ट्राई, आई विल टॉक टू द टीम, आई विल ट्राई टू गेट यू नो मे बी सम एटलीस्ट 1 or 2 सेशन स्पेशली फॉर डिजिटल मोर. ठीक है, एज ऑफ नाउ वी हैड 3 डिजिटल सेशन प्लान फॉर यू एंड दिस वॉज द लास्ट डिजिटल सेशन. Rather than covering lot of theory, because I am again telling ki if I go for flip-flop and counter whole theory, it will take a lot of time. But I have taken very important questions and tried to explain the concept. ठीक है, please reply if you have any doubts, and I hope you might have enjoyed learning these concepts. These are little important and tricky concepts. Tricky concepts. Fine, Pritish, yeah, definitely. I have, even in this slide, I have some more questions, but time is running short. Okay, otherwise I would have covered. So I believe ki Just go through this video again. If you have any doubts, please tag me on the GradeUp app. I will help you in all possible doubts. ठीक है? Yeah, if you are willing for more questions, definitely I'll try to put up, one more session like this. ठीक है? I'll talk to the team. Do not worry. Okay, dear students, so please take this question as a homework for you. Please take this question as a homework for you. ठीक है? Aditi A. Yeah, A is the correct answer, but with A, it will also be D. Again, I'll tell you this question has two answers. Because whenever a counter is a mod 40 counter, counter is also a, I've already told, counter is also a frequency division circuit. ठीक है, तो if a counter is a mod 14 counter, it will also sir, behave as a divide by 14 counter. Divide by 14 counter. Rajasekhar, again, yes. A as well as D. Shubhangi, A as well as D. Is this correct? ए के साथ डी भी होगा, ए के साथ डी भी होगा. ठीक है, इफ अ काउंटर इज अ मॉड 14 काउंटर, इट विल ऑल्सो बी अ डिवाइड बाय 14. ठीक है, डिवाइड बाय 14 काउंटर. फाइन, यस, ए एंड डी विल गो करेक्ट. इज दिस करेक्ट? यस शुभा रेड्डी, ए एंड डी. फाइन विद दिस स्टूडेंट्स, आई राकेश तलरेजा हैव टू साइन ऑफ फॉर दिस सेशन राइट नाउ. आई विल ट्राई टू पिक अप मोर ऑन दिस. यस, सो मोनिका, व्हाट मिस्टेक यू हैव गॉट? आई एम नॉट एबल टू लुक एट द प्रीवियस कमेंट. सो ओके स्टूडेंट्स, एज ऑफ नाउ आई विल साइन ऑफ विद दिस सेशन. यू कैन, यू शुड नोट दिस ग्रीन कार्ड डिटेल्स फॉर दिस सेशन. फॉर एनी मोर क्वेरीज यू कैन रेफर टू द ग्रेड अप ऐप. प्लीज कीप लर्निंग, प्लीज कीप प्रिपेयरिंग स्मार्ट. एंड टू नोटिफाई यू टुमोरो, इन द नाइलिट सीरीज आई एम हैविंग क्वांट सेशन टुमोरो. So, I have already had one quant session last week, speed time distance. This time I am going to cover in the quant the very important concept of time and work. ठीक है, तो see you soon tomorrow once again on time and work discussion, same time 5 PM. Okay, till then I am signing off. Bye bye, study hard and stay safe at home. Yeah, thank you everyone. Bye bye. And do not forget to hit the like button if you have really enjoyed studying. Okay, bye bye. Yeah, thank you so much, Shikhar.